inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher, unlock the fire in you, cause real women don't bitch, no,
Hey, 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 thank you for joining me on the Real Women Don't Bitch podcast. This is your proud host, August Crenshaw, aka Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. I am the number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs because building mental muscle is necessary in order to implement successful business strategies. This show has been created for the woman who is not excuse-driven and needs help building a profitable business. I will be interviewing women from various fields who are willing to break the silence on struggles that specifically affect female entrepreneurs. Welcome to a show where I and guest speakers from time to time share our methods that help us beast our business no matter what is going on in our lives. Whether you are an online or brick and mortar business owner, this show is for you. We will hit every angle, personal, professional, and spiritual. Why? Because on any given day, you get hit with shit from a scenario involving one, more, or perhaps all of the above. It all impacts you and your mindset towards your business. I have made it my personal mission to provide a space where we dive deep into the BS we face on a day-to-day basis. Okay, you guys, I'm in rare form. That means that I'm coming in here and I may be going off a little bit more than usual. I want to talk about professionalism today. And the reason why I want to talk about it, because I am so sick in dealing with unprofessional entrepreneurs who also, happen to be some of the most sensitive mofos that's walking on the planet. And it just tickles me to death because the very thing that the vast majority of you don't want to deal with is the exact thing that you do. And I'm going to use a couple of examples because they come from specific people. You guys don't know who these individuals are, but if you happen to listen to my podcast, just know that I still love you. But what you did, unfortunately, is a good example to talk to the people. And so here we go. I started this group. And in this group, I'm going to be serving people. And one of the things that I did was said, hey, I've created this group to do X, Y, and Z for you guys because I know that this is missing in the entrepreneurial arena. However, as a great leader, part of how you become that great leader is by inquiring with the people that you intend to serve. Can you all just answer these basic questions for me? Come here in this group. I don't need you posting all day. Just answer a couple of quick questions for me so that I can really get a handle on what it is that you need. And after almost 10 days of little to no response of me going live on different occasions to spark up some level of interest and saying, hey, you know, you do have to RSVP for this event that's coming. When I say no one, I mean literally no one responded. Well, no, I take that back. One woman did. She was like, hey, I'm not going to be able to make this next one, but I just want you to know I'm excited about this. And it's funny, right? Because if these same people were getting married, hosting a birthday party for their children, had some type of party that they were throwing to celebrate their launch, if they needed RSVPs, they would be upset because they can't stand that people wait to the last minute. Individuals need headcounts for the space. And I'm not even going to go through all the reasons why we've grown. We don't have to listen to list all of the reasons why RSVPs are important. But these women, they were not opening up. They were not responding. They were not saying, you know, I'm sorry, I'm not going to be able to make it at all. And when I called them out on it, one individual, she was like, yeah, well, you know, I'm super busy and I'm not going to be able to be in the group and I can't do all this. And I said, sweetie, but that's not what I asked you. I just asked you to answer a couple basic questions so that I could understand how to serve you. And it's very telling, right? Because ladies, it's really sad that when someone says, what do you need and how can I serve you? We don't speak up very quickly. And what do you think? Do you believe that you're not worthy? Or you just don't believe that it's real because no one's going to serve you in that manner? Time for you to wake up and change your mindset. But anyway, that's one example of a lack of professionalism. And here goes another one. I had a young lady who was like, oh my God, I want to work with you. I'm going to do this. As a matter of fact, I need to talk to my spouse. And this, we're talking tonight. Matter of fact, I'm messaging him right now as we speak because I know that this program that you're going to offer is absolutely amazing and I need to jump on it right now. Okay, well, when are you going to talk to me? I'm going to get back with you tomorrow. That's perfect. Well, tomorrow came and went. The day after that came and went. The day after that came and went. And finally, after 3 days, I sent a message and said, hey, you haven't got back to me and the program is still moving according to schedule, and this is what you're going to miss out on. And there was still another 72 hours before that individual responded to me. And here's the crazy thing. When I first sent them a message, they told me Messenger was not the best way to get to them, that they always have their phone in their hand, but they don't have Messenger on their phone and to text them. And so then when I text them, it still took them 72 hours to get back with me. And they were like, oh yeah, the kids are in school and this happened and all of these things were going on. And I'm so sorry, but yeah, I have an opportunity that's much more lucrative and it's going to have a faster ROI. So I'm going to pass up on that. But there's so much value in what you have to offer. And I remember giggling to myself, you know, ladies, you're never going to get where you want to be in your business if you don't start telling the truth. Because after having a very long, detailed conversation with this woman, one of the things that I know that she didn't have is that she didn't even have a true, thorough understanding of how to take this business concept that she had and actually make it produce a product that would have a fast return. The methodology that she was about to implement is one of the slowest ways to get paid in the entrepreneurial arena. And I was just sitting there laughing to myself and saying, yeah, you and your spouse must have had a conversation and he wants to take the money that would have been partially invested in what you wanted because he can see where there's going to be a faster ROI for what he wants. But the crazy thing is this individual was already warring with the fact that her dream was something that keeps getting backburnered. And so I'm just sitting there and I'm listening to the double talk and it's like, be real with me, don't lie. And you all know how that feels when someone gives you an answer and you're like, that's an excuse, or it's not true, or it's double talk, or it doesn't line up. It gets up under your skin. I just sat there and shook my head. I was like, wow, that's crazy. But instead of following up, because we talk about the fortune being in a follow up, this offer in particular wasn't important enough for me to do all of that. It wasn't a $4,000 offer, and that's no disrespect to the person, but I'm not getting ready to blood, sweat, and tears for $100, $200, $300, $400. Don't get me wrong, they all add up, but I'm not going to be chasing people at a low investment amount when I could just be cool and the right person who's mature enough to accept it will. But my issues were with that, you know, she was like, oh, wow, you know, this message came on Sunday, LOL, you know, oh, my bad. And it's like, really? I said, the only reason why I reached out to you is because you said you would reach out to me that day. And instead of saying, oh, my bad, I'm so sorry, I was supposed to reach out to you the next day, but my dog died, you know, whatever it is, you didn't even acknowledge that you put your word out there that you would do something that you didn't. And for you too, if this was anything else that was regular, I would let it go. But you were like, oh my God, I absolutely need this. And there's an experience that's wrapped around this situation that it's not just like, oh, in passing and having a conversation. It's like, I absolutely need this. I know that I need you. And for you to put something out there and not do it, and then to still be talking to me like everything is okay, it's really, really weird. And it's so funny because, ladies, you all don't like to sell. The majority of you don't. And not only do you not like to sell, you definitely don't want to feel like you the bugaboo following up with somebody every 5 minutes to get them, you know, to say yes to your product or service. But you don't even make sure that you keep your own word and touch base with people. even if it's to turn people down, when individuals reach out to me in Messenger, I say, hey, thanks for reaching out. This isn't something that I need, but, you know, if I think of you and our relationship grows, then maybe in the future I can refer you. Just think about what you're doing. You guys want people to share your posts. You want people to comment on your videos. You want people to like your business page. You know, stop sending friend requests and in 5-second letters sending a link for somebody to like your business page. At least have the damn decency to go on my page and look at the business I own. Go to my page first and like my shit. Once again, where's the etiquette? You just come and be like, hey, you want to let them panties down and let me hit that? That's basically what you're doing. You acting like I'm a prostitute and I'm just supposed to give it up to you. Stop doing that. I had another woman. I'm like, who in the hell is she? First of all, I don't do makeup like that. Second of all, I have someone that I get the one thing that I buy Mary Kay from. I already have someone. And the only thing I use on my face is the tinted moisturizer. I'm not a fan of the color schemes of most Mary Kay makeup. But I had this woman come and say, oh my, I'm going to hit my goal for this month. Can you buy something so I can hit my goal? And if not, can you donate $3? Excuse me? And she even sent another message that said, well, I know you're not really into the makeup, but can you please donate $3? Is that how we coming? Because what I don't see you doing is buying my new book that I have available. What I don't see you doing is saying, when the shoe's on the other foot, what can I give to you? I had another woman. Hey, I want to get on your podcast. I just released a book and I wanted to, you know, tell people about it. I said, well, what's your favorite podcast that I've made? And all of a sudden it's blank. Sweetie, this podcast is not about you promoting your products, but you will get to promote your products. This podcast is about you explaining your entrepreneur journey in order to empower another sister to see what is actually possible. But you have no etiquette. So let me give you all some etiquette if you didn't know this. And this is definitely some etiquette that I was taught. I didn't know. I was told to do this and it makes perfect sense. You want to be on somebody's podcast, at least do yourself the solid of listening to an episode. Even if it's not the whole episode, try to listen to a few of them because you want to hear the flow of the interviewer. You want to make sure that it's the kind of show that you want to be on, that it expresses values that you believe in. And then when you submit your application or your request to be on their show, be able to say, I align with your core values. I appreciated this message. And can I please be on your show? Because I believe I can bring this level of value. Anybody that's got any type of love for themselves does not want any and everybody on their podcast, because this is an opportunity for you to get exposure. I can tell you right now that this podcast has been downloaded in South Africa, Singapore, Malaysia, Argentina, Brazil, China, Canada, the UK, France, Russia. I can go on and on and on. And I've even, matter of fact, Singapore, which I am proud to say that I had a client from Singapore. I'm not trying to let any and everybody get on this platform and get blessed. And I don't know who you are, what you about, and what you feed into my people that are listening. So come like you have some sense. Look at all of these ways that people just don't exercise professionalism. And here's the thing. Yes, I have made some mistakes. Yes, I have been spammy, because when I came into the arena, people were like, oh, just do this. And even though it didn't feel good, they made it seem like because it was online, it was different. Baby, when I realized that it was no different, and it's like, no, you bring the interpersonal skills that you have in the physical to the virtual. I was like, hey, y'all, I'm sorry. I messed up. I was spammy. I won't do that anymore. And I fixed it. And I also made sure that I never trained anybody else to do those things. So, yeah, you got an opportunity to be a little bit unprofessional sometimes. You have the right to make some mistakes. But you guys have got to stop doing things to people that you do not want done to you. And before you listen to this episode, say, yep, yep, that's right, that's right. That's why I don't do this stuff, because it's so easy for you all to do that. I want you to think and say, even if it's not the example that August gave, what level of behavior do I exhibit where my professionalism can be in question? See, when it comes to professionalism, a lot of you are worried about whether or not you do or don't have on a collar shirt, whether or not when you're speaking, you're articulating all of your words like this, making sure that your background, you know, happens to look good when Professionalism is about behaviors, relative behaviors that show that you operate with a level of dignity and respect towards other fellow entrepreneurs or your clients. It is not this look that corporate America has said that you have to have. Step your game up and be a real professional. That is your boulder for today. I'm looking forward to hearing your feedback. And guess what? Some of you need to know how to be professional on sales calls. That's right. Have you went to www.closethesales with an S yet and got your pre-order copy of my book? You need to get it because this is not sales like you've ever heard it before. You're going to learn how to sell according to your own unique brand and personality, not according to a script, according to the way an authentic woman wants to do it so she does not feel like she's being sleazy, shysty, no scare tactics, no fluff, no bull. Make sure you get it. And for those of you that get the book, you're going to get an opportunity to have a 7-day free trial into the Close the Sales Private Club where you see how I help you take this to the next level. And after that, guess what? It's only going to be $47 a month, y'all. $47 a month to be in a group where I'm going to give you boulders on a consistent basis to help you keep that muscle up so you can sell, so you can make more money in your business and then do monthly trainings and give you reward points that are cash value so that you can utilize them when you let them build up to get services from me that you might not have been able to afford without having that to subtract away from the cost. Constantly creating ways to help you get to your next level. If you don't know what I'm talking about and you want to message me on Facebook, please don't send me random friend requests. Message me first. I'm not just accepting random friends. I just did a major detox. I went from 1,109 people down to about 214 as we speak. If you want to be connected with me, then make sure that I know who you are. Let me know that you came from the podcast so we can go from there. Okay? You guys have an amazing day. I can't wait for you all to come back because guess what? On Friday, the powerhouse Renette Upson Bush is going to be here. And she want to know if you got some skin in the game. She want to know if you all in or nothing. Let's do this, y'all. I love you all. Have a great day. Deuces. Thank you for joining me today. Remember to cultivate a mindset that is biased towards taking action. No bitching, whining, or complaining. Here, our mantra is, real women don't bitch, we get shit done. See you next week as I continue to bring you what you need to keep your head in the game and beast your business. Don't forget to hit subscribe and leave us a 5-star review. Would you like a specific topic covered? Have a question you would like answered live? Then head on over to realwomendontbitchpodcast.com. Subscribe to my email list, hit me up, and I got you. Interested in being a guest speaker? You walk the walk? Then you can sign up on the website too. This is your number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs, Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. Signing out. Deuces! Inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher, unlock the fire in you.